Hey guys, what's up? It's Isabel. How are you guys? How's your day been? How's your life? Great, that's good. Now, let's get to the Man Eater Mascara by Tarte. Here's the thing, I made an order from them a while ago and then I got the stuff back and it wasn't the right products that I'd ordered. Roll the clip. Look how cute it is. I love it in the little unicorn wrapping paper. It's... yeah, I can't actually remember what I bought. It was like one of those sale things for Black Friday. I don't think this is my order. Tarte Girl Pretty and Perfect Eye Set Lights Camera Lashes 4-in-1 Mascara Limited Edition Rare Treasure Eyeshadow Palette, Water Foundation, Shape Tape Concealer, Blister Card. They didn't even get the card right. Yeah, this isn't my order. That happened and safe to say I was not really happy, but I messaged Tarte, sent them an email like, hey, this is the wrong order. Can I get the proper order or what do you want to do about this? Blah, blah, blah. And they're like, so sorry about that. Keep the products as an apology. Make another order if you want to, send us the shipping details and then we'll give you the original discounts and pay for your shipping. I was like, yeah, that's fair enough. Cool, cool, why not? But I have not been able to make, I'm just talking with this. I have not been able to make another order quite yet because I checked it out, but things have been out of stock and I'm like, ugh, I just want to wait for it to go all at once so I can order it all again. But you know, it might take a while for that to happen, and I'm not in a rush, so what you gonna do about it? But because of that, I have had the opportunity to wear the Man Eater mascara instead. I have been wearing this for about a month, I would say now, so I feel comfortable that I know what it's about, if that makes sense. Honestly, I'm never gonna buy it. Because it just does not meet my requirements. It's like, I don't know, $30 mascara, which would probably be like $45 or something, or like $40 Australian. I'm just like, eh, it's a lot to spend on a mascara that I'm not really happy with. I just, you know, it's just not it. I find that the brush is really quite weird. It applies the mascara kind of thickly, but it's easy enough to brush out, which is good, but it's just like, it's weird that it's so clunky from the beginning. My lashes, I found using this product, aren't very long. There's just like, you know, standard, like you could get it at a drugstore mascara, like I'm wearing it now, they're not long at all. So Better Than Sex is like the holy grail mascara. I've not been able to find one better than that, although it does. I'll review it another time maybe, but everyone knows Better Than Sex is like the mascara to beat. And this did not beat it at all. It's nice enough packaging. I found that this mascara was really easy to apply. It was, you know, it's mascara. It does what it's meant to do, but it doesn't go beyond what it's meant to do. Actually, that perfectly wraps up this mascara. Wow. You can reapply it 2 to 3 times and just, you know, it'll be a bit longer, but the kind of, it's kind of like a spidey look, if that makes sense. It's like, I don't know, I find it a bit spidery, but it's not too spidery. That probably makes no sense, but they just go really long and just kind of stiff if you reapply it a few times, which, you know, can work for some people, might not work for others. It just really depends on you and your preferences. One good thing about this though is I find that the brush easily applies to a lot of lashes at once, or if you want to like focus on it individually, you can kind of just twist it in and just kind of buffer it out. One thing though that really, really, really made it like 100% that I'm not gonna buy this unless I'm in a crisis is that after, you know, 6 hours, something like that, you've been out and about, or even like 3 hours you were working and then just like blackness under your eyes, you know, like the mascara's just transferred underneath onto your eye bags, which is not a cute look, especially when you try like wipe it away and then what happens? It looks like you haven't slept in 10 years. Now, I'm sure you could stop this if you like caked, you know, but Who has time for that when you're getting ready in the morning and you've got like 5 minutes before the bus comes? Haha, not me. So I haven't tried it whilst caking, so I don't know if that would stop it or not, but I do know that caking definitely helps it stop from transferring. Overall, I give it a 6 out of 10. It's okay, it's slightly above average, it's just not. That's just the best way to put it. It's not. Do I recommend you buy it? No. I don't, I'm sorry, I really don't. Unless they like, I don't know, revamp it, do a different formula, just fix something about it, then no. No. Thank you guys so much for watching. That is my review on the Tarte Maneater mascara. I hope you guys all have a great day. Thanks for watching. Yeah. I find that the brush, whoop. I'm sorry. Yeah. Hope you guys have,